Well, everyone, lovely weather we have been having lately. It seems like the sun really has just come out to play, and I'm just blowing a load over it. That's perhaps the wrong turn of phrase, but you know, the sun shining down on me, shining down on all of us, and so to commemorate this event and the start of the Persian New Year, I would like to take a look at the Cars trailer from the outstanding folks at Disney Pixar, an obscure little studio. So, enough of this horse shit, let's just dive right in, shall we? So right at the outset, you can tell you're in for a treat with this one, from the oral experience to the just flashing imagery before your eyes. Oh, let's do it. They say he becomes Danico Blue, awash with Danico Blue. Disney Pixar's Cars. And he wants to give him a little bit of sizzle. Sally with a waterfall behind her, she's a bit of a baddie. I will admit that. Oh, you saw that? She's a bit of a klutz. An instrument of speed and aerodynamics. He misses the train, dives right past it, goes through the puddle, they go through the puddle, get went wild. You got more talent than one look, nut. Oh man, that's a cool move. The cool cars are there too. Booze, 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 booze. He jumps off the body of a dead car, goes through smell. Oh, his tongue unfurls like the red carpet. He winks at the cars to left, those little cars. And in the movie, they do flash their boobs at him. Their boobies. And then does a cool move, turn right to go left, drifting. Oh, goes out right in front of the king and chick aches dicks. Oh, then this is a bit of levity here. Cartoon moment. He crashes straight into the cacti. He crashes right into them. And then they go, oh, I'm in hillbilly hell. My IQ was dropping by the second. Oh, then Doc, he's awesome. Vroom in the stadium. Oh, yeah. Whoa. In the courtroom, he's just making Sally wet. She's purring like a engine. Her engine is a purring like a... And then jumps out in front of the piston cup. Eat it, wet, Nick. That's classic Mater line reference to the piston cup. Luigi and Guido, white wall tires looking cool. Then Mater doing an in-place donut. Spin, spin, spin. Yeah, that was fun. Daggum. Disney Pixar's Cars and Ka-chow. And that seems to be where it concludes. Suddenly I see something more sinister at work in regards to the Cars' extensive use of costumes and disguises and what have you. Is this mere cosmetic fun, a bit of lighthearted tomfoolery on their part, or does it suggest some sort of infidelity or secrecy at work? Look at this Mater outfit, for instance. Who is this clown trying to fool? He's looking like a certain member of the Flavortown royal family here. Who's he fooling? He's just straight goofing right here, Mater. What are you doing? When you look at Sally, on the other hand, I'm quite disappointed in her outfits. They're mere palette swaps. Being the sexiest and, frankly, just baddest character in the film, I would have expected more tantalizing stuff from the Blue Beauty. Unfortunately, we didn't get any of that. I'd like the cowards at Pixar to take note of my demands. Moving on, I think it is especially inappropriate that the sheriff is portrayed as having the ability to take forms of what may be the designs of neighboring police jurisdictions. Also, plain clothes, outfits, that should not be a thing in real life either. Plain clothes officers, that's just entrapment. Much less the Cars world. This is sickening that this... what I think of a utopia still has this sort of corruption, blatant corruption in it. Sickening. The sheriff, biggest bastard of all, I will say that. It's also very shameful that the king, the Dinoco king, would ditch his longtime sponsor, the aforementioned Dinoco, for some new flair and a simple tune-up. Disgusting. I can't think of one single time that my trust in an oil conglomerate has ever been misplaced, and I'm of course not counting the Exxon Valdez spill or Deepwater Horizon or the Atlantic Empress incident. Or here's a particularly egregious costume, Union Jack Ramon. Very disheartening to see the all-American rebel show affinity for those, well, let's just be frank here, those tea bags. So I'm left with many questions. What are these costumes? What are their purposes? Are these displays of alternate colors signs that an imposter has taken over? Are these replicants of some sort, a split personality, or are they just one and the same, necessary disguises for their more covert missions that the Cars go on? In conclusion, I'm just left with more questions than answers, frankly, but I would like to thank Dan the Pixar fan for his help with the research this episode. So thank you, Dan. And folks, as always, if you don't hear me, I have been assassinated. Thank you and good night.
Ah!
Help me!